Shalom lechem, shalom. I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, and welcome to Treasures in the Hebraic Roots. I'm often asked, how do we study the Bible through the Hebraic roots? How do we understand the Hebraic roots of the Bible? And I always answer, it's pretty simple. Through the Ruach HaKodesh, through the Holy Spirit. To ask God through the Holy Spirit to enable you to understand the scriptures in context. But another thing that the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, has shown me over the years is that everything is more spiritual than it is physical, and everything in the Old Testament is a shadow of the New. And I pray that this will also help you and bless you as it has blessed me over the years to understand the scripture. So we're going to have a look at two examples today in the Bible. First example is the story of Abraham and Isaac. We know that Abraham was asked to sacrifice his son Isaac. This is a foreshadow, a picture of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus, who sacrificed his life for us, who died on the tree on the cross for us, so we can have salvation and eternal life. But in the story of Abraham and Isaac, when we look at it through spiritual eyes, we not only see the first coming of Jesus, Yeshua, but we also see the second coming. And we're going to have a look at that. We know that Isaac asks his father, where is the sacrifice? And Abraham answers his son in the book of Genesis, chapter 22, verse 13. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him, a ram caught in the thicket by its horns. The ram represents a shofar. By the way, this is the first time we see the shofar in the Bible. But what does the shofar really represent, and what does it mean? Well, a shofar is actually a foreshadow of the trumpets in the book of Revelation. And we know that with the sound of the trump, we meet the Lord in the air and go home. In fact, the Bible says in the book of 1 Thessalonians 4:16 that the dead in Yeshua, the dead in Christ, will rise first, and then we meet the Lord in the air with the trump. So right here in this marvelous story of Abraham and Isaac, we see the first coming, and we also see the second coming. And the ram was stuck in the bushes with the horns. Once again, we see that everything is more spiritual than it is physical, and everything in the Old Testament is a shadow of the New. So when you read all these things in the Bible, and you begin to look at it through spiritual eyes, you begin to see the connection with the book of Revelation, the book of Zechariah, the book of Daniel, and it all comes to life. Let's take another example in the Bible. Yeshua, Jesus, was confronted by the Pharisees. And he answers them in the book of Yohanan, John, chapter 2, verse 19 and 20. Jesus, Yeshua, answered them, destroy this temple in 3 days, and I will raise it up. And what do the Pharisees answer him in verse 20? The Jews then said, it took us 46 years to build this temple, and you're going to raise it up in 3 days? He was speaking about his body being raised from the dead. They were focusing on the physical. Everything is more spiritual than it is physical. And when you don't have the Holy Spirit like they didn't have, you don't have the Ruach HaKodesh, you cannot understand the spiritual element of the Bible. That's why it's very, very important to realize this when you are studying the Word of God in context. Until next time, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, sending you blessings from Israel in the name of Jesus, Yeshua, HaMashiach.